Hey everyone, welcome to Niagara Graphics. Following the series of tutorials so far, we have done this list of chapters in the best possible way. And now I'm going to start the chapter of transforming the objects. Transform means any kind of change you made to an object, which will include five types of changes, which are moving, rotating, reflecting, scaling, and shearing. For the matter of fact, I must tell you that Illustrator has provided an all-around assistance for transforming any particular object. What I mean is that whenever you draw an object, you get transform option up here in the control panel. You have the options related to transform here in the menu bar. And then you have transforming tools here in the tools panel. Like we have two arrow tools for moving. Then here we have rotate and reflect tools. Along with it we have scale and shear tools. And then we also have a free transform tool. Also, we can have the transform panel docked here in the docks panel like I have it here. You can activate this panel by going to the Windows menu and clicking transform. So we are surrounded by the transforming options, and now we will discuss all these options starting from the concept of moving. For applying any transformation, you obviously have to select that object first. For selecting object, we use black arrow tool. Let's say I want to move this yellow square. I will select it, and then for freehand moving, you can drag this object with black arrow. For precise moving, double click on the black arrow to open the move dialog box. The values here are representing the last moving you did. Here you can enter desired values for horizontal and vertical movement. You can also specify the distance value along with the angle to be moved. For example, I want this yellow square to move in the direction of 60 degrees by 100 points. I'll type in the values like this, and by checking the preview, you can watch the projected change. This copy button will make a copy of the selected object with respect to the values you will enter up here. Like if I click copy now, it places a copy of this yellow square 100 points away in the direction of 60 degrees, like this. You can also move the selected objects by arrow keys. Each arrow key increment is determined by the values set in preferences of general. Like here we have the keyboard increment value of 1 point, which means every arrow key press will move this square by 1 point. Moving this arrow key with shift key pressed will move it by 10x. Then coming to the options available in the control panel related to moving, here you can specify the x and y coordinates value to move the selected object. For moving in line with the x and y scale, you need to view the rulers, which you can get by going to the view menu, and there you have the option of show rulers. Right now this blue square is at x coordinate 236.319 points and y coordinate 391.183 points. These values are representing the center reference point of the selected object because the center reference point is selected here. If I select the upper left reference point, the values of x and y will represent this part of the selected object. This concept of reference point is also explained in detail in the video suggested up here. You can watch that too from the 7th minute. So here if I want this object to set at x36 and y72 referring to this point, I will select this reference point and set the values accordingly to place this object to the desired location. So this is all about the concept of moving, and in the next video we will discuss the topic of rotating. Thanks for watching and subscribe to this channel for more upcoming tutorials.